Okay, friends, imagine the internet as a super cool amusement park, and websites are the rides and games in that park. Now, there are some bad people out there who want to mess up the fun for everyone. In that context, visualize the internet as a vast network of connected computers, and websites are the digital places you visit on this network. However, in this digital world, there are individuals with malicious intent who aim to disrupt these websites' normal functioning using a cyber attack called a DDoS attack. DDoS stands for Distributed Denial of Service. It's like having a massive, never-ending line in front of your favorite ride at the amusement park. This line gets so long that nobody else can get on the ride. And that's the aim of a DDoS attack, to make a website or game too busy to work properly. DDoS is a cyber attack strategy where the attackers use multiple compromised devices, such as computers and servers, to send an overwhelming flood of internet traffic to a specific target, like a website or an online service. The goal is to saturate the target's resources, rendering it inaccessible to regular users. DDoS can work in different ways, but it can be summarized in three basic steps. First, there's a trouble team. These are the bad guys forming a team of super fast robots, not the friendly kind, who listen to their commands. In reality, these are the bad actors creating a network of zombie computers and devices, often referred to as botnets. Then there is the overwhelming rush. These robots are told to rush to a website or an online service at the same time. This rush makes the website or game very crowded. These botnets or compromised devices are then instructed to send a massive surge of data requests to the target website or service simultaneously. This flood of incoming data is similar to when a huge crowd rushes to grab the last piece of cake at the party, causing a chaotic situation. Finally, complete chaos. With so many robots trying to move to the target at once, the website becomes like a big jigsaw puzzle with pieces everywhere. Total chaos. As a result, it slows down or even stops working. The excessive traffic generated by these compromised devices overwhelms the target's bandwidth and processing capacity. Ultimately, the website or the online service may slow down significantly, or even become inaccessible. The consequences of a DDoS attack can create so many problems. Simply, people who want to visit the website or use the online service can't do it because of the massive demand. The disruptions caused by DDoS attacks result in the users being unable to access the website, much like trying to get on a popular ride at an amusement park when there is an impossibly long line. Then, you have the financial squeeze. The folks who own the website can lose money because they can't run things properly. These attacks can lead to a financial loss for the owners of the website due to the downtime and the costs associated with mitigating the attack and restoring normal operations. But we should never forget about the sneaky tricks. Sometimes the bad guys use DDoS attacks as a sneaky way to do other bad stuff. DDoS attacks are occasionally employed as a smokescreen strategy. While the target is struggling with the attack, cybercriminals may use this chaos to carry out more malicious activities, such as attempting to infiltrate the target's systems or steal sensitive information. But with all of this damage, there are different ways to defend against these digital troublemakers. First, we have online protectors. Some companies have online superheroes who can spot a DDoS attack and help stop it. Defending against DDoS attacks requires a combination of strategies, such as the use of DDoS mitigation services provided by specialized companies, then being ready. Amusement parks need to be prepared for super long lines by having bigger doors and more staff during a popular event. From a website point of view, this means bandwidth and security measures. To be ready for DDoS attacks, online services must be equipped with a scalable infrastructure. This means having the ability to handle a sudden influx of traffic at any time. You can also block the bad guys. Special tools are used to spot and block the bad traffic from causing trouble. These are specialized traffic filtering and analysis tools that can identify and block malicious traffic, preventing botnets from overloading the website or the online service. After that comes the role of implementing emergency plans. Just like having a plan for a rainy day at the park, there are plans for what to do if an attack happens. Having a well-defined incident response plan is crucial. This plan outlines the steps to take in the event of an attack, allowing for a more efficient and effective response to minimize damage. And finally, stay updated. Make sure everything in your online system is up to date. The same way a video game gets new features and bug fixes, your systems and applications need to be always updated and backed up. This helps reduce vulnerabilities that attackers might exploit and keeps the online environment safe. If you're a small or a medium business owner and you find yourself in the middle of a cyber attack, then having a good understanding of the essential 8 is important. So make sure to check the video on the channel to learn more about it. DDoS attacks are an ongoing challenge in the digital space. By comprehending their mechanisms and employing proactive defense strategies, organizations can safeguard their online presence and maintain a secure and enjoyable experience for users. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful and you learned something new, please hit like, share, and subscribe and help spread this content to contribute to a secure digital space. For now, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.